What's the best password manager now in 2023? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question we got. I'm confused as to the best password manager. The several reviews I've read tend to contradict each other as to what's best. I now have information paralysis and I can't decide which to try, but I need to do something. I'm overwhelmed by the number of passwords I have to keep track of. I'll be completely honest with you. I did not expect to be updating this particular topic quite so quickly. As you know, last year, LastPass had a breach, and that's caused me and many other professionals to reconsider their recommendation for password managers. I have an updated recommendation. Cutting to the chase, I am now using 1Password. I switched last year, shortly after the LastPass breach, and in the roughly 3, 4, 5 months that I've been using it, I've been actually quite happy. There are some aspects of it that are a little bit actually better than LastPass. The interaction or the integration with websites and sign-in forms seems to be a little bit smoother. It's slightly more complex to set up, but honestly, that's a side effect of the fact that it's actually a little bit more secure. They've implemented it a little bit differently than LastPass. So that's what I've been using. And like I said, if you need a bottom line recommendation, you can't go wrong with 1Password. Now, I realize that 1Password isn't for everybody. There is no free version, for example. It covers all the platforms, it does all the things, but not everybody wants to go that route. There are two other solutions that I would use if I were not able to use 1Password. One of them is BitWarden. BitWarden, I've played with a little bit, and I have a lot of feedback from both friends and readers who have spoken very highly of BitWarden's implementation. It's a very worthy equivalent, and what's more important for a lot of people is that there is, in fact, a free version of BitWarden. The other solution that I would also look at very, very seriously is a utility called KeePass. Now, there's a difference with KeePass compared to both BitWarden and 1Password. And that's something that I think we want to understand because honestly, before you choose a password manager, this might be a decision you want to make first. The question is, where is your data kept? With LastPass in the past, with 1Password and with BitWarden, there's a centralized cloud-based service that actually stores your encrypted data. Now, that makes a lot of people uncomfortable. It shouldn't, because in fact, the cloud-based data has not been breached. Even with LastPass, there is no indication that any of the encrypted data has in fact been compromised. They did some other things bad, but that wasn't it. Storing things online in the cloud enables you to use your passwords from whatever device you happen to be using. Both BitWarden and 1Password allow you to have a single database of passwords that's automatically synchronized across all the devices you used, including your PCs, your Macs, your phones, your tablets, whatever. KeePass, on the other hand, doesn't do that. They don't have a cloud-based service. They put the onus on you to decide where things are going to be stored. You can have your KeePass database on a USB thumb drive. You could have it on a folder in your machine. You could actually have it in a service like Dropbox or OneDrive, once again, putting things in the cloud. But this time again, it's on you to make sure that things are where you want them to be and are backed up and are secure. Now, KeePass absolutely encrypts the database. Don't get me wrong. It's not like you're storing something that's unencrypted. You are storing something that's encrypted. But the bottom line is that you control where it gets stored. So that's a decision to be made. Do you want the convenience of a service that makes all of your passwords available across all of the platforms that you happen to use? Or do you want to control where that database gets stored? Now, I've listed only three alternatives so far, 1Password, BitWarden, and KeePass, and those, based on both my experience and the reputation I've heard through the industry, are fine, fine alternatives. However, if you want more to choose from, head out to alternative2.net, and you'll find that it lists over 200 100 alternatives to 1Password. There's a lot of password managers out there, way more than I actually would have ever expected. Here's the thing that I want to be very clear about, though, and that is that I don't want you to trust just any password manager. Like I said, there's a lot of them out there with a lot of varying degrees of quality. Some of them are dedicated tools. They were written from the ground up to be password managers. Others feel kind of like some other project needing to have that checkbox that says, yeah, we do passwords too. I'm always concerned about those kind of scenarios where a company that is focused on doing one thing really, really well decides that they need to bolt on this other feature so that they can have a checkbox checked. There are two other password managers that I will throw out, not because I've had any experience with them, certainly not recently, but because once again, they show up constantly in reviews and feedback I hear, and that's Dashlane and RoboForm. Now, I want to be clear. If you have a password manager that you love, and I haven't mentioned it, that doesn't mean I think poorly of it. All it means is that I haven't been able to go through all 200 password managers. That's just not practical. What I want to do is give you the top, most commonly, and most relied on alternatives so that you can make a reasonable choice and come up with a solution that is safe for you. What's important here is that you use a password manager. It's actually less important which one you use, as long as you use one of the quote-unquote reputable ones. Of the ones that I've mentioned here today, yeah, any of those would probably be just fine. What's most important is that you actually use one. I've likened it to things I've said about backing up in the past, which I've also then in turn compared to diet and exercise. The best password manager is whichever password manager you will actually use, because using one is and remains a critical step towards maintaining your online security. Use a password manager. When deciding on which one you want to use, understand where it's going to keep your data, and if that matters to you, which platforms it supports, again, making sure to include the platforms that you actually use, how it makes your password information available on the various platforms you use. Is it only a fill-in when you try to log into a site? Is there a separate interface where you can manage your information? Those kinds of things. How complicated does it feel to set up and use? If you're not going to use it because it feels too complicated, then it's not the best password manager for you. And there are differences across the various password managers. And finally, cost. Now, in my opinion, password security is worth it. It's worth the investment. Not everybody is in a position to make that investment. That's fine. Then make sure you choose one that has a free version that meets your needs. You have lots and lots of options. And the good news here is that most of them are pretty darn good. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/148053. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.